Hello friends, welcome to another episode of Investing Right. So recently I got a list of stocks and its prices of 1989. So it was very interesting. So I wanted to share that piece of paper with you where you can see the prices of some of the prominent companies, what they were quoting at that point of time and what they are quoting now. So when you compare, I just want to warn you something. These companies, whenever you see the price over there, and don't blindly compare it with the current price, because you know, that companies would have given many bonuses, it would have split its shares, they would have demergers in between. So finally, this company would have come to today's form. So you can't blindly compare. It looks very interesting to see like some of the stocks, some of the companies which are very prominent today, how much they were quoted at that point of time, and how the main companies, what they were listed at that point of time, are no more there. So this will give you some learning points for investors. So I wanted to show you this particular price chart and then we'll discuss about it. So you are watching the stock prices of 1989. Okay. So you can see it over here. We'll start with Ashok Leyland, which is relevant even today. It is quoting at 125, but then don't compare it with the price. Don't think that it has moved only 20% after that. So maybe this stock would have split it many times. It would have given bonus. So Associated Cement Company, it is prominent even today. Now it is 2000 and it was quoting only 345 in 1989. Asian Paints, which is quoting 3000 now, it is 226. So this company has given multi-fold return over this last 35 years. Atlas Copco, 53. Bajaj Auto, this very interesting one, it's at 450. So right now also Bajaj might be quoting around 450, 600 rupees. This Bajaj Auto only demerged its Bajaj Finance and Bajaj FinServ and then formed into three different companies. So that Bajaj Finance and Bajaj FinServ, on an average in last 12 years, we has given more than 1000 times return. So that's very interesting fact, right? So this was, if you had invested 450 rupees in Bajaj Auto in this point of time, it would have been a crore badi by this time. Now, Baroda Rayon, 525. Bata India, still very much in action. Now it is around 1600. It was quoting only 89 at that point of time. Bayer Corp, yes, still an agrichemical giant. It is still there. It is quoting around 3000 over there. Now it was quoting 900 then. Bharat Forge, yes. It was 202 then. After that, it has given many splits. Now it is at around 600 or so. Kalyani Investments is the holding company of Bharat Forge. So those who are planning to invest Bharat Forge, the smart way is to go for Kalyani Investments. So those who want to know what are holding companies, see my playlist where I have explained everything. I have different videos which explains like how a holding company is formed and what are the major holding companies you can try to invest. Bombay Dyeing, just a prominent company at that point of time, 162, more than what even when the Reliance was, or even Reliance was quoting, but now it is confined to just a real estate company. Britannia Industries, 112. It's just a coincidence that it is just next to Bombay Dyeing. So the Wadia controlled Bombay Dyeing, those people have taken over this Britannia Industries from Rajan, who was controlling Britannia Industries. So Britannia Industries is now quoting around 3,500 rupees or so. Now it was 112 in 1989. So now Bombay Dyeing is a part of Britannia Group. Brooke Bond, 155. Century Spinning of the Birla Group, 2000. Chloride. Colgate Palmolive, another MNC which has given immense returns, 371. Cyanamid, DCM, Dunlop, EA Hotels, still there, yes. Escorts, yes, a prominent company now. It is quoting 74 in 1989. And you won't believe, even in 2012, it was quoting 74. Maybe after some splits. But then now, after that, it had a big rally and it touched 2000 and now it is quoting 1200. Finolex Cables, still a prominent cable maker, 430. Then now it was at 50 rupees 7 years back. Now it is quoting around 200, 300 also. PSFC, yes, one good company, which is the holding company of Gujarat Narmada, and it has investments in other companies also. That company was quoting 161 then. I have done a video on GSFC, please watch that. Two fertilizer stocks to invest. So Grasim Industries, which is quoting 1500 now, it's a prominent Birla Group company. It was quoting only 137 then. Now Grasim Industries holds shares in Ultratech Cement also. So when you buy Grasim Industries, you are getting two Nifty 50 companies, Grasim Industries and Ultratech Cement. Hindustan Aluminium, which is also a Birla Group company, it was quoting 325 then. So it was a prominent company then. Hindustan Siba, Ingersoll Rand. Yes, this MNC is almost at this price even now. ITC, it was 106 then, now it is 208. But then don't think that ITC has given only a very small return. It has only doubled. No, that is not the case. Whoever has invested in the ITC IPO in 1977 would have multiplied this money 10,000 times in this last 44 years. Now, JK Synthetics, 92. Kinetic Engineering of Kinetic Honda fame is 395. Kirloskar Cummins, 88. It's a Cummins. It's a good company even now. KSB Pumps, prominent company. It's a borewell motor making company. It's a MNC. It was quoting 445 then. And this was quoting 445 2 years back. Now it is more than 1,000. Larsen & Toubro, the engineering giant, was 128 then. Now it is 1,600. Larsen & Toubro had a major run after this 1989. And I want to add that the Harshad Mehta stock and the scam and all happened after this. At that point of time, the Associated Cement Company, which was quoting 345 at this point of time, touched 2,000 in next 5 years. This Associated Cement Company is to touch 2,000. Mahindra & Mahindra, its very prominent automaker, is at 113 then, now it is 800. It has given multiple return in this period of time. Madura Quartz, people in Thrissur district, Kerala, will be knowing this company. It was at 102 then, now it is no more. The company is not existing. LML, the company is not existing, I suppose. It is LML Vespa, the scooter company. It was quoting 28. Motor Industries, no idea. Mugand is a steel company which is quoting, which is good and performing very well, 125. Now it is gone out of use. Now National Organics, Nirlon, Orke Silk Mills. There's a lot of silk mills and factory related talks over there. Pico Electronics, Pfizer, 80 rupees. This multinational pharma company has given multiple returns after that. Ponds, the FMCG company, was quoting 212. Premier Auto of Premier Padmini fame is 65 then. Raymond, this also has gone out of business and now they are just a real estate company. Reliance Industries, the biggest company in India as of now, was quoting 158 then. It had given numerous number of bonus and other dividends after that. Now it is quoting around 2,200. Siemens India, 95 then. I remember seeing Siemens 5-10 years back at 5,000. After that, again, split or what, something has come up and then it is now quoting. So see the number of times it has gone up. Sharp Alloys is in the same spirits business. It's 103 then. Now it is out of business. Sriram Fibers, out of business. SKF Bearings, 3,020 then. So it was one of the priciest stock of that times. Speak is still there, 67. Tata Steel, in 89, it was quoting 1,460. Can you imagine that? 2 years back, it was at 250. Now again, it is somewhere close to this level. Telco, the Tata locomotive company, is a Tata Motors at 875, but now it is quoting 300. Warm Organics, 177. You may not be knowing this company by name, but then when I say Jubilant Foods, Jubilant Organics, Domino's Pizza, they all came out of this company, Warm Organics, 177. Videocon International, one of the major appliance company of that time, now it is no more there. It has become a penny stock and I don't know whether it is getting traded. Voltas, a Tata Group company, which was good at that point of time, doing very well at 730. Now also, its price is much higher. Vimco, an MNC company, at 32. We have seen the chart, price chart of stocks of 1989. And we are trying to compare it with what it is in 2021. The prices of most of these companies have gone up. So there are two, three learning points and interesting facts in this series. So that is what I want to share with you. One of them was how much some of the companies have grown up, how much these companies have returned wealth to the shareholders. The HDFC, that is the Housing Development Finance Corporation Limited, was a prominent company at that point of time. It was not quoted in that chart. But then HDFC came up with this IPO in 1974. the IPO came, and if you had invested some money in that point of time, 1 rupee if you had invested then, it would have multiplied by 80,000 times in the next 45 years. 80,000, can you imagine that? Look at the potential. Because India was so much with respect to housing finance and housing, so much underpenetration was there. Indian population was available to take this service. And the interesting fact is that now on, for the next 45 years also, HDFC being the leader of the country even now can repeat its success. It can still give the same return to the shareholders for this one. It is possible. Hypothetically, if you can just put in an Excel sheet, it can be proved that HDFC being the leader can continue to grow at the same levels, because we are still penetrated. More and more populations of India, so much consumption demand is there in a country like India for such services. So India can still grow at such a fast pace with respect to housing finance, and this company can grow even the same return. That means what? Your 1 rupee has become 80,000 now. That can become into 80,000 that point of time. So that means what? 1 rupee invested in 88, 89 years would have become 640 crores. So we all know that no one would have invested just 1 rupee in the IPO. They would have invested 1,000 rupees. 640,000 crores you would have got if you had got allotment in the HDFC IPO of 1974. And if you still keep those shares, this I am telling, considering the next 40 years also and company continue with the same performance. So this is not a small amount. Even if you consider take the present value of money and considering 7% inflation, and it will be a substantial amount. This is much in a multiple of the money required for India's Chandrayaan mission 1 and 2 put together. So imagine the wealth created by a company like that. So there are many companies which has given so much wealth. So this is the first point. It focuses on the returns these companies can give to the investors if being loyal and remain invested. That is one thing. Second thing, see the list of companies of 1989. Many of these companies are not even heard of these days. The new companies have come, new themes have come, and this the factory working theme has gone. Now it's all Zomato's and then the digital platforms, CDSLs, IEX, these type of companies have come up. So that says what? If you are planning to invest for long term into individual companies, you need to be a bit more careful. You need to watch what is the trend of the market, where is it heading, where is it going. So the factory related things and most of the textile companies, you have seen Bombay Dyeing, Raymond, and Century Textiles, like spinning mills, all those companies over there, that's all, most of them are gone. They have become just mere real estate companies these days, because they have just removed their mills and they are just making into plot or making into commercial properties. So what that says is that you should open your eyes to the new trends in the market. It also says you need to invest through ETFs, the exchange traded funds and mutual funds. So what are exchange traded funds? How to invest in them? Which are the best ETFs? I have done the videos. Please watch them. So you will get full idea of that. So if you go with the ETF, instead, if somebody had invested in 10 of those companies of that time, he would have gone bankrupt, because if he had chosen the bad ones, he would have lost all his money. But had he invested in a good ETF, ETF means, the, let's say, some banking ETF and IT ETF and pharma ETF, these he would have come up with, after 44 years also, he might be having the best of IT companies, best of banks. But of course, ETF was not available at that point of time. Now you have that luxury of having an ETF of your choice. So you can go and invest in an ETF. Likewise, mutual funds. You can invest in a mutual fund. If you had invested in a mutual fund at that point of time, it would have continually given you return. The fund manager would have thrown out the spinning mills and they would have added some digital platform themes or even specialty chemical themes. So it's always better to keep both your eyes open to the new developments, what is happening in the market and where is it heading. For example, right now, what are the themes, what is driving the market? It's digital platform theme. That is one thing. I have done a video on which are the best digital platform themes available. Please watch that. You will get an idea. And then the specialty chemicals. The specialty chemicals are a thing that has come up later than 1989. So India has become a leader. Maybe even a pharma story started in India in a big way, maybe after that 90s. So Now we have two different themes. Likewise, maybe 40 years down the line, this may not be the best themes what is available. Go with a ETF and a fund managers, mutual funds for your very long-term investments. If not, just make sure that you are just turning your portfolio to keep abreast with what is happening with the market. So not just this, all these different strategies of investing in market, how to keep for long-term investing, how to plan for a retirement. Once you are retired, how to plan your money. Do you really need to have a annuity sort of products in order to help you with investments? All this we discuss in detail in our YouTube channel. We also have a Telegram channel where we discuss these things. And then if you are finding it interesting and if you think that this helps you, please join our Telegram channel and bring your friends also over there. Thanks for watching.
Investing Right. We help you to organize your investments to save for your retirement life and other major goals. In and out of mutual funds is explained. The taxes associated with them. The importance of taking the fund in the name of your minor child in order to reduce the tax burden. How to invest for your child's education, marriage. How to invest in global companies like Facebook, Google, sitting in India with an ordinary share trading account. How to evaluate a fund. What are the funds selected with such evaluation criteria? We also give an analysis of other products like exchange-traded funds, real estate investment trust funds, non-convertible debentures, and stock analysis, especially of holding companies, which holds deep value. No, we don't just cover the definitions, but the in-depth analysis is given, allowing you to take the decisions depending on your risk profile. Share this video with your friends if you find it interesting. Subscribe to our channel. Don't forget to click the bell icon. Come, invest right for a better tomorrow.